It's now time to go around the world. And this afternoon, we are crossing live to Yuri Sak in Ukraine and then Sarah Coates in Israel, who is on standby right now, then to America straight after that. So first up, major developments are coming out of Ukraine today, with President Volodymyr Zelensky claiming Kiev's troops have fully seized a Russian town. Ukraine's cross-border incursion has seen them occupy over 80 settlements, 1,150 square kilometres of Russian territory. For more, let's go live now to Ukrainian Ministerial Advisor Yuri Sak, who is in Kiev. Yuri, great to see you. Bold move by you guys. Why did you make such a big call to advance into Russian territory?
Great to see you too, Erin. We have said it many times that for us, there is only one objective in our defense operations, which is to drive out the enemy from our land and to achieve just peace, to bring to account all the war criminals and terrorists, and to ensure that we help the world restore the rules-based order. So, you know, just when the world was kind of very pessimistic about what was happening in Ukraine in terms of the front lines, in terms of some incremental Russian advances, as our president said, we have been able to surprise the enemy, to surprise the world, and to be honest, to surprise a lot of people in Ukraine, and to give primarily to Ukrainian people, to give us 2.5 years into this war a very important morale boost.
Yeah.
So right now, rightly said, we are controlling over 1,100 square kilometers. It's over 80 villages. And as our president says, we are achieving our strategic objectives in the Kursk region.
So what do you hope to achieve by it, Yuri? And how do you expect Russia to respond?
First and foremost, we have already captured hundreds of Russian prisoners of war. And they will replenish the exchange fund, and they will be used to bring back the heroic Ukrainian soldiers who are kept prisoners of war in Russia. Second of all, of course, you know, we are seeing the diversion of Russian troops from other parts of the front line, because let's not forget that the war continues, and in other parts of the front line, in particular in the east of Ukraine, the situation is very, very serious. Now, thirdly, of course, Kursk region, so that the viewers understand, is exactly the region from where, during just the summer months, Russia has launched over 2,000 attacks on Ukraine. Mm. Glided bombs, missiles, multiple launch rocket systems, artillery. They've launched 250 almost glide bombs on the prefrontal areas from Kursk region. So that's another reason why we had to go in there. And, you know, in a nutshell, the operation in Kursk region has made our position stronger and has considerably weakened the positions of the army of the aggressor.
Yuri, final question. I've got about a minute left for you. It's probably going to take a lot longer than that. How does this war end?
This war ends in just peace, like I said at the beginning. We need to restore the world's base, or we need to ensure that our children grow up in a normal world. And I would like to just stress that the operation that the Ukrainian Defense Forces are implementing now in Kursk region probably would not have been necessary if Ukraine received the permission from our allies to use the long-range weapons to strike Russia deep inside Russia. We need to destroy their airfields from which they're bombing our cities. We need to target their military facilities. This is how we end this war. But of course, this will be a mixture of military success of the Ukrainian forces on the front line and diplomatic efforts of our diplomats.
Yeah, I can't imagine how hard it must be just generally fighting a war, but feeling like you're doing it with your hands tied must be so frustrating. Yuri, our thoughts and prayers are with you. We stand with you here, and thank you so much for joining me tonight.